All right, y'all, arguably the hardest thing about inversions has nothing to do with strength or mobility, but a lack of clarity up here in between your ears. So what I've noticed with 99% of students, with myself included in my own practice, is that the thing that tends to limit us the most is just how we think about the inversion or our fear. Likely you fell on, you know, the playground when you were a kid or something, where you have a reasonable fear to crack your skull on the ground, versus kids will just like throw themselves into anything. So today what I'd invite you to do is to meditate or to focus on what it would look like for you to lift up into that inversion, what it would look like for you to complete the pose without fear and with perfect execution. So for me, this is a great thing to do before I go to bed, because it's not really meditation as much as it is visualization of myself in the future. Meditation would be me being super present. So, you know, maybe before you go to bed, you just sit and consider like what it would look like. I love, as I go to bed, to dream about what might the next day hold, or you know, what it might look like for me to accomplish a certain thing. And while we don't want to grasp at anything, just being able to see ourselves in the pose will make it so much more possible for us to do it. And then as you are practicing the pose, just become super aware of your mindset. So often people will plant their hands, they'll lift their leg, they'll kick, and then there's that moment of, oh shit, and they literally come toppling down or crash on their head. Okay, so try to go really slow as you build into your inversions, and then notice the chatter in your mind. That is more yogic than ever doing the full expression of whatever inversion you're after.